New and exciting innovations in healthcare are now right here in Old Bridge Township with the new addition of the Medical Arts Building at Raritan Bay Medical Center. Today, we're going to give you a first look at the opening of this excellent new facility and give you some insight on what this means to the community of Old Bridge. You'll also see the inside scoop on the recent openings of the Jocelyn Diabetes Center and the new surgery center located in the building. We spoke with the medical directors of these divisions about what makes them unique. Plus, you'll see all of the individuals who help make this facility a reality. So join us as we welcome you to the all-new Medical Arts Building at Raritan Bay Medical Center of Old Bridge.
A member of the board of directors of Raritan Bay Medical Center. I'm also the chairman of the foundation for the Raritan Bay Medical Center, and I enjoy wearing both hats. So, thank you. Thank you for being here. This is a great moment for our hospital. It's a great moment for our township, as I said earlier. We're gonna get right on to hearing a lot about Raritan Bay Medical Center, and we're gonna hear a lot about what's going on, and we have some wonderful guys to talk about it. So the first person that I wanna bring up is a person who's been leading our pack now for the past couple of years, taking on the responsibilities of legislation in our hospital. He's the person that sets policy with us. He's our chairman of the board. He's the folks that we look for as a tremendous leader, and he's been a great leader. And I'd like to introduce Joe Jankowski, chairman of the Raritan Bay Medical Center.
Thank you. Good afternoon, and welcome to Raritan Bay Medical Center. This afternoon, we celebrate a most significant milestone, the opening of our first major building addition in 25 years. You know, it seems like it was just yesterday when I was standing in this very location with a shovel and a hard hat, breaking ground, and here we are. As hospital board chairman, I'm extremely excited to address you this afternoon on such a wonderful occasion. During my time as a board member, I've witnessed significant changes in the way that healthcare is delivered. So much care is delivered in the outpatient setting, leaving the hospital environment for the most critically ill patients. In our efforts to ensure that Raritan Bay Medical Center remains a cost-effective and highly efficient care provider while adapting to the new healthcare landscape, our board challenged our hospital executive leadership to grow services here at Old Bridge to meet the growing demands of the community. Today, we stand in front of that vision turned into reality. This new building is one of the most integrative healthcare facilities in the region, bringing together specialized outpatient services, ambulatory surgery services, inpatient surgical care, subspecialists in the areas of podiatry, vascular, cardiology, general surgeon, and even family medicine will be available right here. State-of-the-art imaging will be available, women's services will be available, and diabetes management will be also available here. Now, we could not have done this without the support of our very, very important partners. Landmark Healthcare, the host of physician specialists moving into this building shortly, and the Township of Old Bridge. It's a partnership that we look forward to growing with even more physicians who we invite to be part of this spectacular project. Now, people say, and I sometimes believe, that good things happen in threes. We had the vision of this wonderful facility. That's number one. If you follow the news, you see that we are in merger negotiations with Meridian Health. That's number two. And if you follow the news, you'll see that Meridian Health is in merger negotiations with Hackensack Health System. That's number three. So, all of you, I say to you, family, friends, supporters, jump in and hang on, because we're going for the trifecta. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Joe. And of course, the hospital itself has to take on the responsibilities of healthcare, employees that we have employed, and all the welfare of all of those factors. And that's only done with a great leader. And our leader is our president, our CEO, and a very, very good friend, not only to all of our community, but to all of us individually. And that's Mike Dagnes. Mike.
Thank you, Russ, and welcome everyone to what I think is a really historic day for Raritan Bay Medical Center and for the town of Old Bridge. I think in my almost 14 years at Raritan Bay Medical Center and in the many things that we've done, I think we've arrived at the pinnacle. As Joe said, this has been an incredible couple of weeks. From our standpoint, the roller coaster ride that we have been on since about 2007, 2008 has been unbelievable and has created whiplash amongst our staff, myself, our medical staff, and the board. But that's over. Here we are now at a point where a facility that we almost sold in 2008, 2009, we're expanding with a 100,000 square foot building that is a combination inpatient surgical hospital, ASC, ambulatory surgery center, an imaging center, physician's offices, the Joslin Diabetes Center, and all in one building, which we did in concert with our partners, Landmark Healthcare Facilities. In mentioning the trifecta, I do want to mention those again. This, in the past 2 weeks, our hospital signed a letter of intent with the premier health system in the state of New Jersey, the Meridian Health System. Following closely after the Meridian Raritan Bay announcement came what is the biggest announcement in the state, I think, to date, and that was the announcement of the merger of Meridian Health and Hackensack University Medical Center and its system, bringing together now 11 acute care hospitals with a geography from North Jersey to South Jersey with the belt in the middle of Raritan Bay Medical Center. And the last thing is, in the same couple of weeks, our superior outstanding nurses were recognized for the third time as magnet nurses. So in conclusion, I know I'm a little dry, but my excitement is sky high. I'm very excited about today. Today is the culmination of a lot of hard work by a lot of people who believed in a lot of people. And that dream has been realized, and the beneficiaries will be the residents of Middlesex County when this building, along with the rest of our services and the services of Perth Amboy, are linked with the Meridian Health System to be part of the best and biggest health system in the state of New Jersey. Thank you all for being here. Thank you very much.
Great words from a great guy. That it puts a lot of time and energy and his whole life into our hospital. Well, now comes some additional folks that are going to lead us in this hospital, okay? One such gentleman also is our medical director, also heads up our catheterization lab. He's a great guy. He's going to be honored at our annual gala in about a month, maybe less than that, as the physician of the year. He's done some wonderful things and very innovative in the way he's taken on his responsibilities. Gives me great pleasure to introduce Dr. Puneet Sehgal.
Good afternoon and welcome. We are living through an exciting times in medicine and healthcare. On a daily basis, it's unbelievable level of innovation happening in treatment modalities, both technological as well as in pharmaceutical avenues. Our patients are living longer and healthier lives. The healthcare needs of the communities are changing across the nation as demographics change. It is my strong belief that physicians should lead the way as patient advocates, and they have the responsibility to work together with the hospital staff and the administrative leadership under the oversight of board of directors to make sure that their institute is able to provide the best and the latest medical services, technology, and the treatments, and is able to adapt to the healthcare needs of the community it serves. The new medical arts building is the culmination of such efforts, and I want to congratulate everybody involved for their hard work and the support. At Raritan Bay Medical Center, I also have the privilege to lead cardiac catheterization lab as their medical director. We participated in Atlantic Seaport trial, which was the first trial on the Eastern Seaboard hospitals, which tested the hypothesis that the emergency as well as subsequent elective angioplasty can be provided in small community hospitals which don't have an open heart surgical backup. This trial's final results were published in 2012, which led to the availability of emergency as well as elective angioplasty in smaller community hospitals across the nation, and this has become a standard of care in the United States now. We are able to provide emergency heart attack care as well as elective angioplasty in our two catheterizations lab in our Pathembo division. The national standard to provide acute care for heart attack patients is 90 minutes. We always achieve this number. Actually, our lab has been doing 60 to 64 to 66 minutes on an ongoing basis. Our center is also designated as a primary stroke center. This expert level of care will now be even more available and accessible to Old Bridge residents as a number of physicians and surgeons, cardiologists, and vascular specialists have decided to make this building their home and will provide medical and surgical care here. I look forward to working very closely with these highly talented and respected medical physicians, and I know that people of Old Bridge will be impressed by the level of care available to them right in their own town. I personally want to thank each one of these physicians for their support. I also want residents of Old Bridge and surrounding towns to know that Raritan Bay Medical Center remains committed to caring for you and your families. Thank you for your time and attention.
Thank you very much, Doctor. The next person I want to introduce is an additional close friend. He's a wonderful guy. He's our chief of surgery. He's got an office right up the road. He puts a lot of time into our facility. He's a very good friend and a member of our board, and that's Dr. Surinder Grover.
Well, thank you, Russ. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm very happy to be here. It's my pleasure to address you this afternoon. It's a very exciting time for all of us. As an orthopedic surgeon on the staff at RBMC for the last 25 years, I'm extremely excited about this new addition as it marks the expansion of our surgical capabilities here in Old Bridge. This new building will be equipped with 5 new state-of-the-art operating rooms, making for a highly proficient environment for surgeons to take care of their patients. Today marks the beginning of a new chapter in the history of RBMC, one that's sure to contribute to continuous growth and success not only for Raritan Bay Medical Center, but Old Bridge Township. I want to thank the Hospital Board of Directors, executive staff, and people of Old Bridge for helping make this day a reality. Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor. I'd also like to, as I said before, when I introduced the relationship that our senator has with not only our hospital, but the entire township and the area, I'd like to have Senator Sam Thompson look, say a few words.
Thank you. I'm delighted to join in observing this wonderful occasion today, and as Michael Deignan said, this has been a tremendous period of for Raritan Bay and for Old Bridge here recently with the recently announced merger, with the finally construction of this building. You know, I have been a guest in your facilities on several occasions. In fact, something in excess of 25 years ago, I happened to be visiting and had a cardiac arrest over there. And because of the fine service they provide, I'm still here talking to you today. I commend Michael Dagnus and members of the board and the medical staff, et cetera, for the wonderful job they've done and the care that they provide to our citizens here in Old Bridge and the surrounding area, what they've done for years and what they'll be doing in the future. And this is so important to the health and well-being of our citizens. So again, I commend you and I congratulate you, and I think, boy, we're on the bigger and better things. Thank you.
That's what's great about Sam. He says the right things and he says them quickly. The next person I want to introduce is taking on the responsibilities of the leadership of our community. It's not an easy task, but it's one that's quite rewarding when it goes right. And I will say that he has been a tremendous help, along with his staff, to the completion of our building. He's been there anytime we needed for whatever the cause was. And he's putting in tremendous hours, not only in his capacity, but around our community. So it gives me great pleasure to present our mayor, Mayor Owen Henry.
Thank you, everyone. That's the problem with going last. Everything I wanted to say has already been said already. And that's why I didn't write anything down, because I knew that. But what I really need to say here today is congratulations. Congratulations. There was a lot of thank yous. But congratulations to the people who had the vision, people who thought that at one time there'd be a big building standing here, and how much work goes into that. I don't think people realize, once you have a vision, then you need to come up with a plan, then you need an application, then you need approvals, then you need permits. And how much work goes into that, and how much of an effort that is. And because of all the hard work and the efforts that were made by the people behind me, by the people in this audience, because of all that hard work, your success is now guaranteed. It is guaranteed with the opening of this building that the things we talked about, the vision you had, is now going to come true. And I think that's when I think everybody will get the really good feelings, the rewards. And I know the people of Old Bridge, the people of the surrounding communities, everyone, as I said, in Middlesex County, including Monmouth County, are going to come to this facility, are going to come to this town, and are going to be made well. We are going to save lives. At the same time, they bring a new life to our town. So I can't congratulate you enough on what you've accomplished. And thank you, and it's an honor to stand here. And I'm so blessed that it's in God's plan for me that I have the opportunity to stand here as the mayor of this town. At this point in time, I can't be more thankful. So thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you. It's a great day for all of us. I want to thank John Lloyd for being here with you and with us, and for all the other folks that are here. We'll get started real soon, so we want to head over to cut the ribbon.
I'm Steve Amakis with the Mayor's Office of Economic Development here in the Township of Old Bridge. We are here today at the brand new Raritan Bay Medical Center, brand new state-of-the-art facility, and we're here to celebrate the grand opening of the Jocelyn Diabetes Center here in Raritan Bay Medical Center. We're going to go upstairs now to see the beautiful state-of-the-art facility, so come on with us. Well, here we are. We're up in the Jocelyn Diabetes Center with President and CEO of Raritan Bay Medical Center, Michael Dagnus. So we're here just to talk about the facility and want to get your input in regards to this wonderful facility that has been built. We've seen it come from foundation to the steel girders being put in, and here we are in the Diabetes Center now. And so we have a couple of questions regarding this. Why did Raritan Bay Medical Center decide to open the Jocelyn Diabetes Center?
We go through on a regular basis, we go through an analysis of services that are really needed in our community. And that needs assessment for the last, I think, 10 years has shown that diabetes is a major underlying issue in the communities of the Old Bridge area, the Perth Amboy area. And we had no structured way to approach that. And we felt that we needed a full-scale, full-scope program that included the diagnosis and the treatment of diabetes, as well as the education and counseling for diabetes. And this center on the fourth floor of this new building is just that entity. Everything that we wanted to offer is offered here under the direction of Dr. Rima Patel, our medical director. And we also felt that rather than try to do the entire service by ourselves, that we would deal with a renowned organization that has really perfected the treatment and diagnosis and education for the public of diabetes, and that's the Jocelyn Center. We were fortunate enough to be able to buy into the Jocelyn Center, and we are I think we're only the second Jocelyn Diabetes Center in the state of New Jersey.
Oh, remarkable. Excellent. Tell us a little bit about the merger with Meridian. When is it official, and what does it mean to Old Bridge and our residents?
Well, let me go back a little bit, because I think I've been on this channel in the past. We've talked about a number of possible outcomes for Raritan Bay Medical Center. And as I've defined it, it's been a roller coaster ride from potentially selling this hospital to possibly merging with other hospitals in the area, and most recently selling to a for-profit entity. Well, all during that time frame, our employees, our physicians, worked very hard to continue to improve the asset. We said, if we improve the asset, we will be attractive to a system in New Jersey, and that's what happened. About a year ago, we were approached by the Meridian system as they're developing their system, and they asked us to consider coming in the system. Naturally, we jumped at that. Shortly after we announced that we were joining Meridian, it was announced that Hackensack and Meridian were merging. So we will be part of the Hackensack Meridian Health System. We will be the center of the state connecting the north and the south, Hackensack in the north and Meridian and its five hospitals in the south. Now, what that will mean is that we will be able to do things. We will be able to purchase things that we could not have done as Raritan Bay Medical Center. We simply didn't have the capital to invest in our two facilities. They do. They want to. So Meridian will do a major capital assessment and will focus on both campuses. On this campus, more than likely, we'll start with a brand new emergency room, expanded emergency room, which we desperately need. It will also bring new physicians to our area, surgeons that will be operating in this facility. We have long said that this is a perfect campus for surgical services. It's accessible, it's easily navigated through the campus, and it's set up really as a surgical campus. This building lends itself to that, and this building also, I think, was one of the attractions to the Meridian system for bringing Raritan Bay into that system.
That being said, and it's a great opportunity for Old Bridge, I want to thank you for all your efforts to make it happen here. So on to, we're going to move into the Jocelyn Diabetes Center and meet with the medical director and move on from there. Well, here we are now with Dr. Rima Patel, the medical director here at the Jocelyn Diabetes Center. And welcome. We want to talk to you a little bit about the center. Tell us what's unique about this center.
I think the most unique part about this center is that we focus not only just on treating diabetes, but we have a comprehensive care approach that we follow for management of patients with diabetes. So it's not just the patient seeing the physician, prescribing medications, and that's it. There are a lot of people who are involved in the care of the patient, including nurse educators, including dietitian. We make sure that the patients get a comprehensive education about their disease and not only just get medication refills.
So training on how to work with the disease per se and different ways they can deal with it.
Absolutely. Diabetes is a disease that patients have to deal with 24/7, and they really don't get a break from it. So a lot has to do with education, and I think that's what we focus on. We have group classes for diabetes that we conduct in this location, and that's conducted by our diabetes educators. Our diabetes education program is actually accredited by the ADA, that is the American Diabetes Association. That's really a benchmark standard for our diabetes education program.
Which we did see, and congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Is there anything you'd like to say to the Old Bridge residents that about the facility or about the people who are dealing with this? And is there a way for them to come in here or talk to? Or just how do they get to know it or apply to come in here?
They can definitely call our office and we'll be happy to see them. We're actually very excited that we have this opportunity to serve the community. Diabetes is no longer a silent epidemic. It is a very big epidemic. Approximately more than 30 million people, actually just in the United States, have diabetes, and a lot of them in the community may need help, not just diabetics, but even pre-diabetics, you know, may need help so that they can prevent developing diabetes. So we have a great center. We are very dedicated. We are very excited to provide the service to the community, and we'll be happy to see you.
All right. So let's get out into the facility and see what they have here. So to help our residents and the surrounding communities with this particular disease.
Absolutely.
We're here with Mayor Owen Henry and Michael Dagnes, the president and CEO of Raritan Bay Medical Center. And our questions are to the mayor. Is mayor, what do you think this brings to our township? What is it all about?
Well, Steve, what it's about is providing services to our residents, and not only the residents of Old Bridge, but it's the residents of all the surrounding communities, which bring them into Old Bridge and be able to provide, I think, you know, state-of-the-art facilities. This is a brand new building, giving the access to the best that is out there when it comes to medical care here, right here in Old Bridge. And I've said it so many times where we hear about hospitals that are closing, reducing services. Here we have a hospital that was willing to invest in our community and provide the services that our residents, they deserve. They really do. We're not that close to New Brunswick. It does take 20 minutes to get there. Here they can be in front of a doctor within minutes. And I think it's a tremendous value to the town. I believe it improves the quality of life in Old Bridge. And at the end of the day, I think it saves the lives of residents who have access to these facilities immediately.
Excellent. That being said, would you like to add anything else related to what this facility has, the amenities and so on?
Thank you, Steve. This building is actually 92,000 square feet, four floors. The first level, we're now on the fourth level with the Jocelyn Diabetes Center. The first level, most of the space is a new imaging suite for the medical center. Brand new MRI, CT, CAT scan, ultrasound, nuclear medicine, all on the ground floor. The second floor is literally an inpatient surgical suite. It's connected by a bridge to the hospital. It has five very large ORs, whereas in the old building, we had two very small ORs. So that entire floor is a surgical suite. The third floor, primarily, I guess, 12,000 of the 20,000 square feet, is a new ambulatory surgery center. We did a joint venture with about 20 doctors, and that should be opening in about 2 weeks. And that's four ORs in the ambulatory surgery center. And then the fourth floor, we have this Jocelyn Diabetes Center. The rest of the building is physicians' offices. We have, I guess, seven or eight physicians' offices. So I don't like to call this a medical office building. I like to call it a medical complex because it is a very complicated building.
Yeah. Are we ready?
We are ready.
Are you going to use? Are you guys going to use? All right, let's go.
No? Okay.
Yay! Thank you, everyone. On behalf of the residents of Old Bridge, I want to thank the hospital administration, physicians, staff. Thank you for investing in Old Bridge. You don't know how much this means to our community.
to have you here offering the services that our community and surrounding communities can use. Diabetes seems to be getting growing and growing and growing. The need is here, and we're lucky. We're proud to have you here in Old Bridge. So thank you from the bottom of my heart, and all the residents of Old Bridge, thank you for being here, for your investment, and for your time. Thank you.
We're here now in the Jocelyn Diabetes Center, and we're here with Heather Cunningham. Tell us a little about your role here and what your function is.
I'm a registered dietitian, and I'm also the education coordinator. So what I do is see patients one-on-one for nutrition counseling sessions, and I also do group classes with two other educators on diabetes and cooking classes and wellness classes and all of that. We are a partner with the hospital. We're an affiliate, so we get referrals from the hospital to see our two physicians. As far as the cooking classes go, anybody can come to our cooking classes, so we have that bridge.
So tell us what happens here in the kitchen, and cooking demos and so on.
We partner with businesses in the community to come in and do healthy cooking classes, not just specific to diabetes. So they come in with their crew and their chef, and I always supplement with, you know, nutritional facts and how to be healthier with cooking. We also have some exercise classes, so some gyms come in, some holistic medicine people come in and do stress management classes. So we like to have that bridge with the community and our practice.
Why is diet and nutrition important to people with diabetes?
Well, people with diabetes know that they should be eating healthier. They just don't know how to do it. How do I incorporate these healthy principles into my lifestyle? So that's one thing that we do here. We teach them some, you know, behavioral changes, little steps onto eating healthier, being more active, and how to manage stress and all of that.
All right, so here we are. We're on at the Jocelyn Diabetes Center on the fourth floor of Raritan Bay Medical Center. So if you're interested in knowing and learning about how to eat healthy and nutrition, come and see some demonstrations right up here on the fourth floor. Now that we've seen the new Jocelyn Diabetes Center, we're going to head downstairs to take a look at the new surgery center here at Raritan Bay Medical Center. So come on and join us. We're here at the new surgery center on the third floor of Raritan Bay Medical Center at the new facility. In a minute, we're going to talk to some of the stakeholders and professionals that practice here. We're here today with Dr. Dada. And we're going to ask some questions about the new facility here. And one of our questions is, what makes the surgery center different than other surgery centers?
The location, it's centrally located, easily accessible. And I think being part of the hospital, you know, it's close approximation, that makes it also easier for us surgeons doing elective procedures to book the cases, have the time slot, and easy and, you know, quick in and out. And I think that makes it easier. Plus, knowing the people over here who are very professional. And it just makes it a lot easier for us to perform our cases in a timely fashion and book multiple cases.
Okay. All right. Another quick question is, what type of procedures are performed here in the facility?
Many kinds. I'm a podiatrist, so podiatry procedures are definitely performed here. Then orthopedics, OBGYN, bariatric, ENT, urology, name it, and it's going to be able to be done here.
So a wealth of different procedures.
Exactly.
Yes. All right. What is the benefits for other surgeons or physicians to come here and practice here?
It's a brand new facility, as you can see, state of the art. You know, no expense has been spared. So other physicians who would want to come here do their procedures would have the latest and greatest of all the equipments, not to mention the support staff, the nursing staff, the administration. They're all good. So I think they're going to be very happy, and it'll be well worth their time, you know, coming in here, book multiple cases, get time slots that they'll be happy with.
All right. Thank you for your time.
Sure.
And good luck in the new center.
Thank you very much.
All right, we're here with Dr. Citrone, the medical director for the new surgery center. So we have a couple of quick questions for him as well. So one is, what makes the surgery center unique and different from others?
Well, what's unique about the center here today is that prior to us building this facility, our outpatient setting in the hospital was at a age and was time for regeneration of that. So what we have here is a brand new state-of-the-art building. And what's a little different and unique about this center as opposed to other centers is that the size, very spacious, very large. The surgeons aren't going to have any issues with that, because in some of the other de novo centers that they've built in years past, very tight, very compact. What's going on in the state today is any new center needs to be affiliated with the hospital. And here at the surgery center here in Old Bridge, we are affiliated with the hospital, and it is still connected physically to the hospital if any needs arise, which unfortunately hopefully may not happen, but we can get to the patients to the care they need, more advanced care, and that's quite unique in that space.
Excellent. What is the benefit to the residents and the surrounding areas of having the facility right here within the hospital?
Well, you know, a lot of the surgeons live here. I live here locally. A lot of people oftentimes they ask you, where do you want to go? What do you want to do when you need care? People often think of, I need to go to New York. I need to go to Philadelphia because the local docs may or may not be, used to different types of care. But what they don't understand is all of our docs were trained in the cities, in New York, in Philadelphia, all the major cities and all the major training centers. And they're the same docs that are still working there, but they decided to come back and work in the area where they live. So that's an advantage to the residents here, is that they can stay locally. It's easy access. There's not the kind of traffic. You pull up, you park right there in front, and your doc take care of you and take good care of you.
All right. And from a standpoint of equipment, what type of innovative or different equipment do we have here that's state of the art, per se?
Right. Well, that's also another part of being a new facility, is everything here is brand new. It's up to date. It's state of the art. We have fiber optic equipment. We have laparoscopic equipment. We have, all different types of high-def cameras. So when the surgeons are operating and they're using laparoscopic equipment, the view is beautiful because all the equipment is brand new and up to date.
I understand. And is the center accepting patients at this time?
Absolutely. We are open, and we have been taking care of patients currently. And anyone can come. We can call. There's a number out, or we have a website. Or just talk to your physician and said, I know there's a new surgery center. Are you involved? Can I have my care there?
Excellent. We're here now with Desiree Reyes, one of the registered nurses here at the new facility. So we have a couple of questions for you. Are you ready?
Yep.
Okay, so what are your feelings about the new facility?
I'm very excited to get started and doing a lot more cases, booking with the new physicians and the existing physicians, and having it be a very successful surgery center.
Excellent. And what are your feelings about, and how does it differ from other centers?
Well, right now, being that this is a brand new center with state-of-the-art equipment, with our two C-arms that we have, our towers that have our HD cameras, everything is state-of-the-art, and it's very exciting to work with.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
We are here again with the president and CEO, Michael Dagnes. He's entered the OR area. And just a couple of quick questions for you.
Sure.
What do you think about this new facility now?
I think a lot about this new facility because it was many years in the planning some time to build. And it adds to what I've already said about this building is a medical complex. It's not a medical office building, and you can see why. Here you have a same-day surgery center. This is about 12,000 square feet, and it takes up most of the third floor of the building. There's four ORs here. We have 19 partners, physician partners, with the medical center, and with a company called MSA. That's the managing agent, but they're also partners. So this is going to be another great addition to the services of Raritan Bay that we offer here in this beautiful building that we opened recently.
Definitely a beautiful building. So what's next on the plans for this new facility, this new center? Anything?
Well, we've opened up our Jocelyn Diabetes Center. We've opened up the ORs. I think the next thing is going to be the Vito Mazza is moving, or is in Woodbridge, and is going to open up in this building as well. And he's going to be dealing with wigs and things of that nature for cancer patients.
Nice.
Plus, he's going to have specialists for nails for diabetic patients, which works nicely with our Jocelyn Diabetes Center. So for those patients that want to go to a spa, they'll be able to do it right on the facility. And that should be opening up in a couple of months.
Excellent. Thank you for your time, and the facility is wonderful.
My pleasure. Nice to have you here.
Thank you. We're here also with Mayor Henry. So I want to see what Mayor Henry thinks about the facility. This is a great facility here. What do you think, Mayor?
Well, Steve, I've been in a lot of, not a lot of, but a few surgical centers before, and this has to be the best one I've ever seen. And what's so exciting to see a facility like this, but even more exciting that it's here in Old Bridge. And, you know, I just can't believe the access the residents have now to this top, you know, top of the field. I don't know if there's any better facilities in the state of New Jersey right now, especially in this area. And I've been to all the local hospitals in this area within a 20-mile radius, and nothing compares to this, the ones that I've been in, for the size of the operating rooms, the equipment, just to see. You can only imagine the fit-out, the cost of the equipment in this hospital, the beds and the operating tables, and just the rooms themselves, like twice the size of any operating room that I've been in. And the access to roll from the same floor right to recovery, and then right across the bridge to the hospital if there's a longer stay needed. So it's the perfect, it is the perfect storm here, and hopefully it'll catch on. It'll you know, we'll get office buildings across the street, and it is the place to be. Instead of, you know, I don't want to speak badly, but who wants to drive to an inner city to get health care? You know, why not come right out here to Old Bridge and have access to better facilities, the same quality doctors, in a more relaxed atmosphere, as opposed to where you park in, or where's my car, or how do I get directions here? This is an easy place to find. It's right off 18. So it has everything going for it. So we expect a tremendous success. And I think it already is successful. So I'm just proud to be the mayor at this time in history where, you know, we have the opportunity to come to a facility like this as the mayor. Hopefully I won't have to come as a patient, but if I do, I know where to come.
Great, man. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you.
As you can see, the new addition at Raritan Bay Medical Center is a great way to access top-notch healthcare right here in town. Today, we saw just a few of the highlights that the new facility has to offer. The building is now open and accepting patients, so stop in to Raritan Bay Medical Center if you're in need of care, and be sure to check back with Old Bridge Television as we plan to bring you more information regarding this new facility as it progresses. Thanks for watching.